But anyways,
all right,
kick off this game.
It's looking like FCC has their, it's called, set up already. Like, they have their roles kind of figured out. They have the Sage, the Killjoy, Mina, who's usually their duelist, is like,
oh, he's like deciding.
He's deciding, but they do have the Omen and the Fade. Meanwhile, meanwhile, Charis is all going Omen.
That'd be so funny if they like stayed with that. Oh, now it's Sage. Okay, but I think Charis is still probably deciding.
Select your agent.
Oh, okay, Mina there.
Oh, Mina is
usual duelist actually went Sky, so.
Yeah, and Master is opting for the Phoenix, it looks like. Oh, Phoenix on both sides. That's interesting.
Yeah.
Phoenix on both sides. Fade. Against the Sky. We got Sage on both sides. With a Jet on Mengu Boy. So it's double duelist on the Charis side and double Sentinels on the FCC side. I mean, it's looking like they are trying to get as much rounds as possible on this defense since they are starting with it.
Yeah, so that's what it looks like to me too. But we'll see. I think this is the matchup that at least you and I are waiting for, McCullen.
Oh, most definitely.
Oh yeah.
I think these two teams, from what it looks like, have shown that they have had the most like consistent play styles and have had the strongest showing so far. It looks like Charis is opting for a B. They're leaning B here. Alright, 3 seconds to the sound of round, start of the pistol round.
Alright, we only see its Master on site, so he does like...
He does get detected here. by the haunt. Mina has... Master's a flash, however... Oh! Trades are going
one
through
enemy remaining.
Charis, and Forn is left on a 1v4. With Mengu Boy.
Planted.
Taking the duel. Very quick pistol and very clean take on the Charis side.
Yeah, really good start for Charis. Looks like another B lean though.
If you notice, FCC is opting for a 5 stinger buy. Yeah, I don't know if Charis is expecting this at all.
Let's go.
Yeah, I don't think so. And they're sticking Sky on B2. So now instead of the Phoenix like last round, it's B2.
Phoenix mollies. So I think they're making it known the Phoenix is here. However, it looks like this, it's a bait for the Sky with a flash. Oh, the trades go through. Mengu Boy with a double kill. And he is pushing their spawn. However, the Omen is waiting for him. Mengu Boy with a 4k. Alright, it's
crazy.
Alright.
Alright, now it's gonna be happening.
FCC's economy is a little rough for them.
Yeah.
It was a nice try, however, the trades just went on the side of Charis.
They really like this B lane, but oh, we see
Mango Boy is looking
for that mid.
Mid. Yeah. Instantly, Mina gets an instant
spike
kill.
Down B.
Mina gets the one dig.
Game crash.
Okay. Game crash.
Looks like we're gonna have to roll back. I think we'll pause the game after this round.
Spike planted.
Unless
Mina is backed.
Yeah, unless they're fine.
Last player standing.
I'm gonna ask them if they're okay with no timeout, just a bug.
Don't even start that shit here, mate.
Okay.
They think they put us in the dirt. They're gonna find out we weren't buried.
Okay. Then it looks like FCC is opting to stay with that result. I mean, they're the ones that crashed and they still won the round.
Yeah.
So, I think they're very fine with that.
I mean, unless Charis says something, but I think we should roll it back.
I'll find you.
I think we should roll the. Okay, I don't know what is happening. No, it's okay. Okay, I mean, as long as FCC is saying it.
Yeah. That's an unfortunate thing.
Yeah.
Come on, let's go!
Down. Mango Boy with 2 kills on mid. Psych with a quick trade.
Last player standing.
Oh, and Blue gets the kill while blind. And Charis takes the 3-1 lead. The buy looks a little rough for the FCC side. However, Foreign is opting for the Bulldog upgrade. Wonder what they're gonna do with this. And Nina has. They're breaking the wall.
Yeah, they're gonna
quick
go up
fight. Heaven control. Mina with a kill, instant headshot. Quick trade, double kill by Psyche. Are they checking the first layer? Mengu Volk kills Master. Psyche kills his Omen counterpart.
Now it's up to the Killjoy.
Bring them down.
Here, okay. Now they know the Killjoy is Heaven. But I don't think this Psyche Killjoy knows
Spike
the
planted.
Omen is male.
Omen is staying half holding steady on this male. Killjoy will have to win out this fight against this Fade. Is she expecting that Fade is so close by? And Ford gets with the instant headshot!
What a shot!
He does have ult. Does he use it?
Oh, I think he's going
for it. Yeah,
for it. Yeah.
Does he have enough time? Psyche is holding this. Oh, Psyche with a 4k for the round to close it out. And gets the chain.
Okay.
It's looking like it's gonna be another mid take for Charis here. With Killjoy. With Killjoy start watching mid.
Yeah, but FCC's joke's over.
Face your fear.
Maybe again. All right, everyone is rotating on the FCC side towards B.
They use the sky ult.
Found
oh, the headshot through the smoke with a spam. Psych TP'd onto the backside and they weren't aware of it. Mengu boy with a kill. Foreign with a kill. 2v4.
One enemy remaining.
Now it's up to
they know that. They know that the omen is happening. Gets the kill. Oh, and it gets instantly traded by Phoenix.
Okay. Charis winning these gun duels.
I think that's been the difference so far. I hope that crash isn't affecting the FCC's performance or anything like that. I hope that Nina's computer is fine. It's just a glitch for a little bit. But FCC, Charis having a great start to this attack.
Yeah, I think they keep leaning towards B because it keeps working for them. So now we see
the sky dog. The sky dog does see three. The jet dashed instantly.
That was a good trade from the omen.
However, the jet was still able to get two.
Okay, we actually see fade and
last
save.
Player standing.
Unfortunate. That's just wow. Gun difference right there. Psych yeah. Finishes off his omen counterpart.
Their backs will be
omen on omen
of
violence right here.
Justice for omen. Alright, I think this is the first actual gun round, right? For FCC.
No, they've had gun rounds before. They just haven't won any of them.
I feel like they've been like poor this. this
past yeah, year. Their economy hasn't been good.
Going up.
This hyper aggression from the Charis side, particularly from the Phoenix, is blue gets the kill onto Mina. Born. The trade's going the way of Charis once more. I think Charis
spike
has had
planted.
Very successful entries. They play with great pace.
Yeah, but it's now 2-on-2. So let's see if FCC can get this retake on site. They know where the fade is.
Last player standing.
Oh! Sage cleans up the kill onto the omen.
Man, they're just gonna keep going B.
It looks like they're just gonna keep going B. This hyper aggression from. Again, this hyper aggression from the Charis side has been very. Has produced results. I wonder when
I am everywhere.
FCC is gonna like adjust to it, make some in-game adjustments. Oh. There is a
rush down mid
here.
Yeah.
My ultimate.
It's
go!
Looking like
watch your eyes.
They just keep feeding this Phoenix.
Flash.
And the Phoenix just keeps getting opening kills.
They are behind them.
Oh! They are behind them.
Bring them down.
They get two. And they have res! Oh! Blue with a 3k.
That was a good try though. Yeah, what do you do? They keep running down towards B side, and you know they keep getting in.
I mean, I think that Charis has been very good with the traits, even if.
Where are you?
FCC gets killed. Like gets the opening pick. They would still. You would get like a double kill, like by Mangu Boy, a double kill by Phoenix, double kill by Blue. Like, they're doing a really great, excellent job on. Oh, but
last player standing.
Sage is by herself, with the bomb.
The tables have turned.
And B main, are they aware of this? She does beat the smoke, so. Wins one duel. She does have res. If she can bait out a peek here, and the enemy sage, the defending sage, has.
Yeah.
Let them try to get through me.
Defender sage, Melon.
Low health.
Yeah, we got the melon milk.
That melon milk life. Oh, you want to hear an interesting story? Oh, how the turntable. So, Darren, do you want to hear an interesting story?
Sure.
My friend, when he was trying to teach me how to read Korean, I was having trouble with between the O sound and the U sound.
Yeah.
And what's funny about it is that he goes, "Hey, it's really easy. Uyu is milk in Korean, and if you form the word, it looks like an udder."
Oh no. I mean, I guess? That is a way to remember it.
Charis does have mid control. It looks like it's gonna be their first time entering A site here.
Yeah.
And no one is A. Mina has pushed all the way through her spawn.
But I don't think Charis knows that Mina is back.
And there's still two players from Charis that are in mid. Mina has.
Oh,
taken out.
Okay, close it up, Jet.
Last player standing.
Alright, Omen, let's see. Theon.
Oh, the blind.
Healing.
The blind gets him.
Last round in the half.
Charis is really just having their way here. Blue, Mengu Boy, and Sight have been really like pulling the weight of the entire team. The Phoenix, who was their top fragger like last game, hasn't even like. I mean, he's 6-10 at the moment, so this team is very strong.
Hey, but that Phoenix has been getting the entries for Charis, so that they can get on site.
Oh, the instant flash?
They do spot that.
This is mirrorless. Throws the molly down so that he can heal.
They're really forcing this beat.
You will not
the res bait?
My own.
They are completely blind. Quick trade.
Spike down, B.
Kill.
You're dead.
Last player standing.
Unfortunately, it looks like that's it for them. A 10-2 half on attack on split.
Crazy.
It's
switching sides.
Quite the scene. This nav is infamous for being defender sided. A recent patch has addressed that, but the main complaint is the map itself is inherently defender sided just because of the short rotations and a lot of the high angles that the defenders are able to hold with the double heaven on the map. But
absolutely.
from what it looks like here, FCC is trying to get this mid-aggression going. Instantly breaks the wall. It looks like they're trying to get heaven control here.
Yeah, pushes the sage away.
Pushing through the smokes, the mollies. The bomb goes down on B.
Embarrassing.
Oh, headshot. So,
one enemy remaining.
Phoenix is holding the site. Wow, Phoenix. Anchoring the site like a hero.
Careful now.
Yeah.
Okay. And there is another force on the FCC side here. But if there's any good news for FCC here, Split is Charis's pick, so I mean, and obviously why? They have the strats for this fight, for this map. So map 2 could easily turn the corner. Turn the table.
Cover going out.
Okay, we see FCC going up.
Middle of the stage. Sage gets three!
Spike down.
Sage. Oh!
Last player standing.
Mangu Boy with a double kill to kill. Alright, it is a 2-12
no charges left.
Score. Map point.
Match point.
Map point Charis.
Yeah, FCC's got to pull out 10 wins in a row to be able to tie.
To be able to force overtime, yes. FCC.
All right, we finally have an A push, something we have not seen yet.
Something we have not seen this entire game. The dog wasn't able to see anyone. Are they aware that the jet is on A?
They gotta clear it off.
Spike down.
Then we pull this one. Korn. Korn gets two.
I got the spike.
Last player standing.
Right now it's just the Omen, and they know he is.
Omen. Oh, Team Defenders Ace. Yeah. Absolute domination on Split. Absolute domination on Split by Charis. Again, I just want to remind the audience that it is Charis's pick. So, FCC does have their map next.
Did you see my mess? Oh my god.
Yes.
Yeah, I did, but I can't type Korean, so I couldn't whisper back to you.
It's okay. Is it okay if we take like a 5-minute
break? Yeah.
Yes.
Sorry. Thank you.
Yes. So there will be a 5-minute break on the stream. I think there's a... I think one of the players from Charis... something came up, like has to make a phone call or something, and but this is a good time for FCC to really like talk about what went wrong for them in that map, how they're able to adjust, because I think that, and I really don't know like what went wrong. I think, well, quite frankly, like Charis just decided to run like 5 rush B every single time, and I think the trades just went their way. They were able to, and like there's really no strategy to it, so I don't know what type of adjustments like FCC can make. Maybe like maybe a little counter aggression on their side, just so that to get that easy control. But
it's been good entry and good holds,
yeah,
on the site. They were getting good trades and winning the gunfights.
Yeah, the post plant was good, everything, the clutches went their way, Can't really talk about like the defense much because we only played 3 rounds on defense. So, I mean, they were able to win pistol and kind of snowball from there.
Yeah. Hopefully, FCC can reset, and we'll see a better map 2 from them, which is Fracture.
Yeah, and it, again, this is their map pick, so and do you know who's starting? Is Charis starting a defense?
Yeah, Charis is starting defenders. So when they get back, okay, we'll have everyone switch.
This is a very with the map the way it is, I think FCC starting on attack, if they can utilize the map well, they can really have a great start on it. Again, my view on Fracture is always that I think it's one of the stronger attack sided maps in the game. It's literally the only map that gives the attacking side a free split on both A and B sites. So, with very little resistance. So, if they can get some rounds rolling early and often, I think it'll be very good for them, and we'll be able to probably, hopefully, see a map 3. Which is Lotus, yeah, which has never been played.
I want to see people play on Lotus.
I want to see people play Lotus. It is the newest map. It's never actually been banned, but it's also never been picked. So Lotus has always been the third map out of a series that went on the weeks that it was available. But all those series ended 2-0, so it's never been played. Game 3, map 3 will be on Lotus.
Yeah, what are we waiting for? Someone...
I don't know his in-game name. One of the players had to make a phone call. He notified the mods prior to the start of the game that he is going to have to speak to someone. Okay.
All right, they're back.
Okay, it looks like Charis is ready. Oh, we need to tell them to switch. Darren, please remind them to switch sides.
Looks like FCC needs a minute to...
Oh, one of them... Also, one of them, seemed to have disconnected. So we're missing a player. I don't know if they're trying to...
Yeah, I think he needs a minute or something. But because game 1 did go quickly, we do have time.
Yeah. Oh, it's Melon Uyu. That disappeared.
Oh.
Oh, he's back.
Back. Alright, everyone, let's switch quickly.
Nasser is still on the defender side. Okay.
Yep, we're just gonna have like 5 minutes of us just talking in the lobby in the VOD.
Oh yeah. Really don't know what else to say.
That's true. We are just waiting.
See, this is like, this is when it's good to have like sponsors. So we can just like run commercials.
Kindred Worship, please sponsor us.
Kindred Worship, please be in the musical halftime show. Oh, someone on chat asked, what was the best thing about the pizza I had tonight? I thought that the cheese was very fresh, so it was like a very good slice of pizza. Like the creaminess of the ricotta on it was very good, and it like added like a lot of like great flavors.
What kind of pizza was it?
We got a Parmesan meatball pizza, or that's the official name of the pizza, I believe.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, I had like, as the name said, it had like meatballs, just tomato sauce, and then some like cheese and stuff. But I don't know, that like, that ricotta was just like, it was just very good that on ricotta. The pizza.
Yeah. Man, pizza sounds pretty good.
Yeah, it was a good pizza. Also, while we're at it, do we know when the next has the teams playing next week scheduled the next games already, or
let's see. So the next week games, or well, technically this week, so week 4, it'll be Faith Christian versus Grace Ave and San Diego versus Charis. So, but the games are not scheduled yet. We will have to check on them and see. Oh, are they switching someone out?
Okay, I see.
Oh.
Matt Lanchungs. Matt Lanchungs. For those who don't know, I played last game, and he is one of the best performers. So it's looking like after that, let's call it what it was, a stomping. They wanted a little bit better, performance-wise from their team. You know, substitution maybe the adjustments that they need.
I guess so.
Okay.
Hold on. I'm gonna go and tell them our rules if Melo Nuyo is gonna stay in coach.
Yeah. So for those in the chat, I just wanted to clarify that we do allow someone on the coaches, slot. The rules that we have set for it is that they are not allowed to speak while the game is going on, with the exception of timeouts. And that is because even if they're not playing, that's still an extra set of eyes and ears that can switch cameras between the players. So the last thing we want is like any unfair advantage from one of the teams.
Yeah, we do have a point system, and I did just check right now that With the switching out, they are still within the max cap, so
okay,
good. Yeah,
okay, that is good. And again, for those who don't know, we have a point system in which the teams have to stay within a certain value, and it's Immortals and up is 5 points, Ascendants is 4 points, Diamonds is 3, Plat is 2, and Golden below is 1. And we do have to say there is a soft cap at 10. However, if need be, the hard cap is at 15. And that's, we had the soft cap, one, to make it fair, but we felt it was necessary to put a hard cap at 15 just because, I mean, this is no one's full-time job, and we just want, and sometimes it just doesn't work out and people just can't play. So the 15 gives each team that cushion to, in the case of emergency, be able to play someone that is able to play for that particular night.
Alright. Okay, I think everyone is ready, so we'll start.
Okay.
We'll start
game map two. Fracture.
Sorry, give me one sec.
All right. It's looking like there is it's looking like Foreign sticks with his Killjoy pick. Usually plays the Sentinel for FCC, and it's looking like he's staying there. Matt Lung Chung's is now playing Sky and right. The initiator, and Mina is going back to his comfort pick of Duelist. So I guess that substitution is the adjustment so that they are able to put Mina onto the Duelist.
Alright, so what is happening here? Charis has not chosen.
Choose your agent.
Characters yet?
Mangu Boy. Okay, it looks like Charis.
Oh.
Oh, Blue was able to switch to initiator. Oh, that was very dangerous. They almost went triple duelist.
Yeah, three duelists.
And since I knowing Charis, it was probably completely accidental, and they were just like, they just couldn't decide who plays whom, and they almost accidentally chose three duelists, because that has happened to them before, where they couldn't decide and they ended up choosing like three smokes at once, three smoke characters at once, which is rough to say the least, just because you don't have a diversification of the utilities available to your team.
Yeah, they went two duelists last game, right?
Yes, they had last time. They had Mangu Boy, and well, the 248-434-5508. call it for free pizza. As duelists on the Jet, yeah. And the Phoenix now, and they are both sticking onto their duelist roles, with Blue sticking to that initiator role. And Psych, so they pretty much, yeah. Psych with the Omen.
They have a Raze instead of a Phoenix now.
Yes, and I think that's my calculation, just because it started with the because if the swap from the Sky to the oh, what a flash!
Yep, they get that info that
they have sand control. Blue here. Pushes the smoke, but unable to get the trade. Matlin chugs with the opening kill.
Here.
4v5.
Wow, they've completely gotten sight in an instant.
Are they aware that Omen is within his own smoke? Or within the smoke?
I don't think so.
Oh, Omen gets... Mangu boy holding dish, holding drop here. Trying to see if anyone makes a
careful
mistake
here
and peeks this. He is aware that someone was on the tower. Oh, he does get blinded.
Shadows traveling.
Yeah, this is a sticky situation.
Sticky situation, just because this is a problem having two duelists. They don't have anyone. However, they get two!
Last player standing.
Oh, 13 health. Omen gets a triple kill. And the opening pistol. Alright, this is... Again, this is good for FCC. They needed that pistol round, the first pistol, as a confidence booster in order to just, like, again, start off strong and really just, like, try to force this issue and this match into map 3.
Yeah. I hope the switching out of players didn't rustle the feathers of Charis. I mean, Charis just has to play they've been playing.
Oh wow, Mina!
See another A rush.
Put your eyes!
Pushing.
You're out.
Take hold. Last player standing.
Okay.
From raids.
Four people alive, however.
Yeah.
Not ready yet.
But Charis did save that round. So they will have a full rifle buy this round, and it looks like Mina is the only one upgrading to a Phantom. Matlin Chugs does have the Bulldog. And other than that, it's just a bunch of SMGs.
Time to mobilize my pack.
Looking like another A push, like a hard A push here.
Hawk out!
Yeah, I mean, if it ain't broke, you don't need to fix it.
Joke's over! You're dead!
Feeling safe.
Mangu boy.
Kick. Oh, what a flash!
Excellent flash! The blinds are going, but...
Blind.
Oh, wow!
Wow.
Wow. Winning their force. This is about as good a start as you can get. Money is broken on the Charis side.
Yeah, FCC is just forcing it down onto the site and... Getting the entries, getting onto site.
It looks like they're going D on this side this time around. Let's see if this Sage can really hold up.
Wall race.
It's an instant wall.
Okay, Charis knows there's one towards arcade.
So they're just feeding. Oh, Mangu Boy with his fast push onto site. Is he aware? He can catch a timing here.
Mango boy.
Maybe get one, but looks like Matlin.
I've got your trail.
Mango boy gets one. Mango boy gets two.
Mango boy.
Huge.
He's gonna run now.
Mango boy runs away. Mango boy. Matlin Chuck gets one.
Okay, what a 3v4 now.
3v4, it looks like the attack side is rotating to A. Mangu boy is here, he did get 2, however he only has 26 health. He hears the utility, so he's calling for the rotate now.
Oh, but they gotta rotate fast. They're already getting onto site. Oh, I don't think they know Mangu boy.
Oh, they saw!
Ooh, what?
The sky saw!
Spikes down.
Oh, blue gets a kill with the marshal. Okay.
We're going out. Blinding.
Satchel out. One enemy remaining. Last player standing. Oh, Matt Lynch with the ace. Sixth man of the year.
They all turn towards Sky, but not the. Or I'm sorry. They all turn towards the Killjoy. Under sight, but not towards the sky.
Matt Land Chugs coming in. It's okay.
Now
it's 4-0. Oh, it is a B split, but Charis does have has a full buy here.
Here. Let's see what we get.
Are they aware? Oh, not, they heard that. They now know.
You should run.
Seriously, oh.
One enemy.
Mengu boy gets three of the flank.
Down B.
And he gets a spike.
Mengu boy with the flanks. Wow.
And Sight with an instant headshot on Foreign, and Charis is now on the board. FCC still has a, I mean, they still have rifles with some light armor on some of the, couple of the players. So, it is still very winnable. Meanwhile, Charis is still, the money is still a little bit rough. Sage is forcing onto the marshal, and Raze is on the judge.
I've got your trail.
Joke's over. Hey,
wow, looks like
wow. This is a on fast TV. Push.
Yeah.
Oh, Mina. The opening pick. Oh, the rock brings rocket does not get anyone. But Mengu boy with the Empress.
He knows one is in tower
his
here.
Tower. He's gonna have to win this fight here. Gets that lunch and he does.
One enemy remaining.
Wow, actually, Charis with the retake.
They know that last player is main. Oh, they picked up a gun that didn't have any bullets.
Mengu closes it out.
Oh, that was almost dangerous. He picked up a gun that did not have any bullets in it. He could have lost. That would have been the round if. Oh, if Master knew that Mengu boy had to reload. Wow. Okay, Charis gets two wins in a row and forces FCC on a pretty rough buy against rifles. There is another judge going on to 2484345508. I'm just gonna call him Rick from now on. If you know, you know. It's a hard B push. Counter flash by the sky. Phoenix Wolves. Oh, instant headshot. Oh, Mengu boy sees all of them.
Yeah.
Oh, Sight drops the bomb. Aiming. 2v3.
Oh, the Omen can cut the ult onto B.
Last player standing.
Oh, so I guess how it wins out against Mina. The Omen does get a free spike plant planted here. And he pushed all the way to their spawn. Will they be aware of this? No. The other two players are rotating all the way through the spot. Oh, he heard the footsteps.
Gonna get some Omen on Omen violence.
Omen violence!
Oh but the sky is sticking.
The sky is sticking. Yeah. Your duty is not. And they get the res for. They get the eco res off, which they need because they are broke. It's looking like Rick over here is still buying the judge. Even though he has money, he really wants this to work.
I guess so. He's really hoping to come towards A.
Mengu boy, who has been popping off in this game, looking like he's gonna be peeking A. Is he aware that all four of the five players are gonna be here? Oh, he walks for the flash. Loses the duel against Matlan Chugs.
The judge gets two!
Blue gets a trade! 2v2!
One enemy remains.
Oh!
Oh. And it's not this... Kimpion on the site.
One enemy remaining.
Oh, but he makes the wrong call.
Shadows traveling.
Oh.
It is again. Omen on Omen.
Oh, Sight wins out with the instant headshot. And the game is now tied. Wow.
4-4.
Charis got
cover going out.
Punched in the mouth, but punches right back. Wow.
All right. So now each side has won 4 in a row, lost 4 in a row.
Yeah, but
we'll see,
FCC's buy is looking a little rough again once more. However, the last time this happened, they almost pulled it out. So, you can never count this team out.
That is true.
Barrier created.
Oh, Masters by himself on this lurk on the dish side. Is
Mengu Boy
is
pushing?
He prepared for Mengu Boy? Mengu Boy!
Almost whiffed,
opening
but...
pick. He knows that it's not me. Oh, he knows that it's not.
Recalling my bot.
Alright, Rick here hears the other team rotating. But Blue?
Blue smartly retreats back to site. With the smoke, he sees multiple players, confirms that it's...
Blinded.
Great flash, however, there's four guns staring right at him.
Joke's
they
over.
Will get a few.
Spike planted. Here.
Okay, Mengu Boy is actually in tower, and I don't think
Mengu
they.
Mengu Boy is in tower.
Mina
kills him through the smoke.
Last player standing.
Oh, Psyche can clutch it. No, the force works for FCC, and they get upgraded rifles. Oh my gosh! That was very, very close. That was pretty scary from the point
great.
Of view of Blue. When he thought he flashed them and there was four SMGs shooting straight at him. He was not gonna win that fight. It's looking like there's gonna be another...
Blinded.
Okay, Sky gets the info.
Sky gets the confirmation on the info. Omen with the smoke. Here it comes. Are they aware that Mina is all the way down?
You should run.
Looks like they're gonna the Kill J ult lower. You're beating it out.
Oh, good patience.
Oh, got spammed through the smoke. He's down to 26 health.
Got your trail.
FC is throwing all the ults they have at Charis right now.
Sight gets. Oh, Master gets a kill with Spike a quick trade. Tangamsan. Tangamsan gets double kill. Mengu Boy pops Empress once more. Oh, but
one
Mina gets the kill.
Remaining.
Oh, Sight once more on this clutch. He knows that one is tower. Is he aware? Of the sky in gen. Now he
is.
He knows where both of them are.
So he's gotta go quick.
Oh, forming the instant headshot from this tower. And FCC wins back 2 in a row. It looks like Charis will have to save here. Couple of upgraded pistols, some one SMG so far, and some light armor. Looking like it's gonna be 7-4 for FCC, but with the way this rounds have been going, like, we just don't know. Do they have a save in the? Oh, they confirmed that it's an A. Confirmed the info buff for A.
Going up. Watch your eyes.
Let's see how they hold up. FCC really likes to just get in there and get on the site. They pop the Phoenix ult. Actually, no one
clears clear sight.
Oh, but unfortunate raise ult. Didn't actually get anything.
Grenade! Spike planted.
Mina gets a kill. Did he get the double kill?
Most of the FCC is still in aiming.
Yeah. Oh, the blind. That's. Oh my god, that gun is broken! How do you kill someone at that range?
The last player standing.
This is not looking good. He was gonna. The only way he wins that was if he hits 3 of the sickest headshots that
last round before the switch.
Hit. Alright, last round, and the AWP comes out for the first time this match. Master has opted to buy the AWP. If you watched the previous games, he is the primary AWPer on the FCC side. He's been the only one buying it. And it looks like he's gonna peek B main here. Does he find someone? Confirm the information on B.
I think he might just be waiting for a peek.
Yeah.
But. Actually.
If you look at the map right now, there's no one at A.
Oh, Mingo Boy actually.
Mingo Boy with this monster flank! Mingo Boy sees all, sees them rotate. He will. This. Oh, but Mina is watching.
Mingo
Boy has to win this out. Oh, Mina!
Oh, but the raise is still here?
The raise gets one. They are now all rotating onto A. With blue being the only one here.
Seek them.
Pop seekers.
Found one.
Oh, but Forn with the instant headshot. Now, time for Sage. The turret was not working.
30 seconds left.
Oh,
spike planted.
But Omen doesn't
see Omen.
I've got your trail. My ultimate is ready.
Oh, she has res. The psych. Oh, the AWP! Master gets the kill with the AWP. Well, they know where both of them are. Matlan chugs. Here's the people with the blind.
Last player standing.
Wow, what is that? 8-4 on the attack for FCC.
Switching sides.
Wow.
Alright. This is good. This is a good game. Charis still has a chance on attackers. This is an attacker-sided map.
Yeah, it is. Again, it is an attacker-sided map. It's looking like there's going to be a solo push on the top side of the map here by by Rick over here. And with 4 people leaning B. However, if you look at FCC setup, They are prepared for the V-take. The Killjoy util is here, and there's two people watching the arcade side. That setup is actually pretty strong, especially on pistol. So
yeah, it's pretty good. Oh, but all three players going for good.
Oh, no! You... All my players are there! All my players are there! Wow!
But because of the Raze's sacrifice, they get onto B.
They get a free... Oh, wow! Mega Boy and Psych with a double kill on the... On the tower. All of them are blind. 3v3 pistol retake here. Going out. Samgyeopsal will have to get some value here. She does!
One enemy.
Psych, it's two!
Last player standing.
Psych. Oh, Matt Lunchucks with a forehand pistol. Coming in and really saving FCC here. Matt Lunchucks is saving FCC.
We know what we're doing. Trust each other and we'll be fine.
Wow, Matt Lunchuk is 20-5. It looks like that substitution is really paying off.
I guess so. But Charis can't let this get to their heads.
Yes.
Wow, that ultimate line actually hitting all the players.
A double P from me and Matt Lanchard.
The Fade is actually pushed out of B.
Oh. Oh, this is interesting. Rick over here is able to walk all the way to... Without getting seen. Oh, he got seen by the turret.
Charis playing really slow this round.
Blue kills the turret. Oh, and the alarm bot. Oh, he gets.
Spike what is down happening? B.
There's kills on kills, but the spike is down.
With 30 seconds left.
Yeah.
3v2.
Mango Boy only 13 health.
He does have Devour. He gets one kill here, and he will be able to heal!
Only 14 seconds.
I have this fight.
One enemy remaining. Last player standing.
Unfortunately,
oh, Mango Boy has HP advantage.
Oh, Mango Boy, Mango Boy.
Oh, oh, Madeline Chun hits that headshot.
Closes it out.
Oh, Mango Boy, if he hit one of those bullets, he wins that round. With Matt Lunchuk's at 33 health. The sheriff does do 55 at that range, so he would have really finished that game, that round. But we have the buy from Charis here. Charis has been pretty adamant about putting Rick on the top side of the map by himself. They really trust him to make some plays here. However, there's three people pushing. Oh, he gets a kill! But Madlung chugs with the instant trade. Mengu boys all the way on the defender's spawn. Psych gets an opening kill. Psych slows drop.
Yeah, it looks like FCC, they actually wrapped all the way around the drop.
Are they aware that Mango Boy is at their spawn, though? No, they are not. Oh, Mango Boy He needs to get value with this.
Oh,
Mango Boy dancing! Mango Boy!
Player standing.
1v1. Thorn versus Sakya Sakya.
Turn out.
Oh, Thorn with the instant click.
This is it out.
So with that kill plus the defuse, Thorn has...
My ultimate is ready.
Her has lockdown online. One of the most powerful, one of the more powerful ults in the game here. Charis is still able to get a buy, but it's looking a little.
Placing sentry.
I don't know what they are feeling here.
Recalling my bot.
Like they are placing forcing it. So this is it. If they win this, they have a chance. Oh, never mind. They're opting to save for. It looks like they're opting to save for 12.
Yeah, so let's see what they can grab with the save here.
Shadows traveling.
They have like a general spread goal.
Watch them run.
Oh, but the omen.
Oh, that was a little awkward there. Psyche is aware of the Phoenix in heaven because they tried TP. Okay. It looks like it's the rest of his team is being a.
No, actually, Matlin chugs.
Matlin chugs pops the Seekers. And so he now they're aware it's an A hit.
Yeah.
Pardon their vision.
Moment on site, let's see if we can hold this.
Oh, he whiffs every bullet!
Off
the bomb goes down.
Spike down A.
That's a little embarrassing.
Flawless.
But they do get the flawless here. Okay. 12-4. For Lotus.
Go Lotus.
Charis with the buy.
I've got your trail.
They will cover.
Mango Boy pops it all.
Wow. Mango Boy is good. Get some great value, but Master spams him through his smoke.
Spam.
Can't go there.
Alright, FCC actually pushes Charis away from B.
Oh, losing Empress is massive.
Fade knows there's people sand.
Oh, Psy gets the kill on the thing!
Spike planted.
Psy gets a kill on Thorn, but gets traded. 3v3 retake. Batman chug.
Here. One enemy remaining.
Going everywhere, only Sky is left on site.
Last player standing.
Oh, and gets Matlin chugs. Now one on one.
Win this fight! What a flick! What a flick onto the head! Blue in the clutch! Oh, they won that round, but their bye still looks pretty tough. They're gonna have to like string out these rounds. Something like it's gonna be a guardian on the sage and rifles all around. Oh! Shotgun onto Raze. Oh, he has Raze rocket. So it looks like he's gonna try to get the value over here. He hasn't gotten a kill with his ult so far, but
drop.
Oh,
spike zero. Down B.
And they get the sage with the off.
Satchel out. Satchel out.
Oh, four and
spike
the
down
bomb.
B.
Blue does get the kill.
One enemy remaining.
I wonder what's the timing on that that smoke there.
Time to
now,
hunt.
The
scout destroyed. Hawk out. Blinded.
Oh, they know the. Oh, they see the bomb.
Hawk out.
They know that he has
blinded.
To go to them. But they're pushing out. So this could be a mistake. They
last
dice.
Player standing.
Blue. With the kill. Madeline just sees him. Blue gets. Oh, 30 health. Oh, Madeline shoots.
Defenders.
Sky on sky clutch. Wow, that was a close game, but oh, that was a close last round. However, it does go to FCC. It is looking like FCC. Okay. It's looking like map 3 Lotus.
Alright, for Lotus, losers will choose the site, so that's actually...
Yes.
It's Charis choosing the side, right?
Yes, Charis choosing the side.
Yep. Alright, looks like they will stay defending.
And it's looking like Melon Uyu is now subbing back in for Master. So
yeah, that shouldn't change the point standing, so it should be fine.
I mean, yeah.
Alright.
So Matt Len chugs the sub did work out for FCC, and looks like Matt Lunchard is staying. So he was their best performer last round. I don't know how. I've never seen either of these teams play on Lotus before, so I know about as much as anyone else does.
All right, let's get this game going. Map 3 Lotus.
The one thing I know about Lotus is that the strongest character in the map is probably the Killjoy. It's the only map in the game where the lockdown covers all three maps. Like, it's big enough to cover the entire map. With Foreign playing Killjoy, but it looks like he's hovering onto Sage this round. Will that be a mistake? Because he's been performing really well on that Killjoy. But 248-434-5508, otherwise known as Rick. Is looking staying with the Sage. Sykes staying with the Omen. It looks like it's gonna be an Omen on both sides. Yeah, so Foreign does lock in the Sage, so he's not opting for the Killjoy. On what could be Killjoy's best map. And FCC is now opting for the double duelist comp with the Reyna and the Yoru. This might be the first time that Yoru has been picked in this tournament.
Ooh, exciting to see that.
Yeah. Mengu Boy choosing Jet. He has played Jet before. He has performed very well on the Jet. Blue, looking at the Charis side comp, there's no flash. They have the Omen blind, but it doesn't really count as a flash. It's a more of a nearsighted effect. Meanwhile, the FCC side, there's two characters with the flash, with the Sky and the Yoru. And again, with the Reyna and the Omen as pseudo blinds, again, they create that nearsighted effect rather than an actual full blind. So, good luck, Charis. You're going to be pretty much blind this entire game. You run to the wrong side, you're pretty much going to be blind this entire game.
Those blinds of flash will be really useful for the entry. Maybe we'll see Charis actually giving up sight for the retakes.
Yeah. So, we'll see.
It's like a
looking like it's going to be a B hit.
Yeah.
Which is interesting. But the good news for Charis is they have two players on B, which is actually like a weird setup. Alright, Nick confirmed. Multiple guns. Smoke does come in. Mango Boy does not get it.
There.
Mina gets the kill. Mango Boy over here with Thorn. Mina gets two kills on the A side of A Link.
Step up stage on stage violence.
Last player standing.
Oh, it's all up to Mango Boy.
Mango Boy, oh my gosh! Mina with the ace. But Mango Boy almost ended that. I think the overheal with Devour saved Mina there. Wow.
Okay, first round going to FCC.
And it's looking like there's gonna be another B take here with Mango Boy this time solo holding B. Never mind. Blue on the fade is the one holding B here and opting for the shotgun. He hears them. He hears the formation. He hears the dog.
But he doesn't want to give it away.
Oh, he shoots the clone.
Amina getting the kill.
No charges. Wall race.
Yes, he's back.
Shoots
on
the Yoru clone.
Spike planted.
Oh, Mina gets the kill. Mina gets the kill.
Oh, but the race.
Mina already has Empress here. Mina already has Empress.
He's gonna be able to pick up at once.
Great double peek.
One enemy remaining. There.
That Rick over here.
No one's looking.
Oh, Rick gets two, unfortunately. However, it is a 2v5. He needed a stronger gun than a pistol if he was gonna turn that around. Here comes Charis' verse by. Again, looking like they're still favoring this, FCC is still favoring this B hit. With Mega Boy aggressing, actually. Oh, never mind, they're favoring a C hit. If Mega Boy gets aggressive here, he might be able to catch the timing.
Charis hears that FCC is going forward C side.
Oh, Mango Boy.
Oh, Mango Boy! Oh,
he has his gun out! Oh, they dashed out. Dash they dash out. Oh, Psych! Psych with the kill onto Mina. Turns the flash. Gets one.
But FCC, down.
FCC gets one caught in remaining. Spawn. Oh, clean first round. The only one that died is Mango Boy. Excellent comeback. First rifle. Mango Boy. Money's a little rough for him, so we'll see how he does here. And FCC does get enough for a full buy for everyone. So I wonder what Mango Boy's buy will be here. Oh, someone was one of his teammates was able to buy for him. Okay. First full rifle run, and again, FCC going with the C. With the C lean. Oh.
I guess they're waiting for a flank. But doesn't spot anyone. Sage actually rotating out of C?
But Mega Boy should hear it. He's right by the door. Oh, dude.
Yep. Oh, dude.
They walled over the wall. Oh, Mina with opening kill, but Sage gets the instant trade. 4v4 retake on this B side.
Spike planted.
Sage pushes the smoke and gets one. Mina gets blue.
There. Satchel out. One enemy remaining.
Grenade! They know where the raise is. Just kind of play around it.
He has bot, so. Oh. The crossfire was set up. One by main and one by CT spawn, so. Mangu Boy with the easy kill over there. Oh, not Mangu Boy, Matland Chunks with the easy kill. My apologies. Okay. Charis is now back to this kind of like four semi half buy type economy. They're gonna have to really like try to make it expensive for FCC.
Mangu
Boy retreats. He heard a lot of footsteps. B.
Who's next?
The Euro. Oh, Mangu Boy gets killed and drops
spike
the bomb.
Down B. Here.
Euro was able to pick it up, and the ult ends.
They're falling back.
Mina is back here, destroying the wall. So.
Here.
Should hear that. Care should hear that.
The hunt begins.
Oh no, she lives.
Spike planted.
My ultimate is ready.
Three. Still 3v3.
Last player standing.
Oh, Mina tried to knife blue.
Oh,
the
no.
BM.
But no one is immune to fear.
Oh. Looking pretty rough here for FCC. Well, I mean, they have their full buy. Money's not looking the best for FCC. If Charis can win one here, they might be able to like break. I don't know. They probably break the money, which will allow them to put them in a position to be able to tie this game. Again, there's this like weird kind of strategy on the Charis side where they would instantly wall C main and just abandon it. I mean, the rotations have come in because they heard the breaking the wall, but I don't know if I like that strategy.
I don't know if it's intentionally a fast rotate because they didn't see anything, or if they want to focus.
Oh, Mangu Boy with the instant dink! Mangu Boy gets one kill on the flank. They're aware that Mina is all the way in their spawn, though. They drop the bomb.
Spike down. C.
Is Mangu Boy aware of the person on top of the wall? So, again, like I think Charis here has to really rethink the strategy on C. And it's looking like Rick over here has switched to C with Let's his flush them ult, out. The raise ult. But unfortunately, it's looking like this is the first. Blue gets the first shot. Nice.
You will not get your try.
They burn the res, and they use the Sky Seekers.
Yeah, but first A hit. Actually, Mina. Oh, they're rotating for B.
Mengu boy gets one. We need to not push this smoke.
Spike planted.
Mengu boy pushes the smoke. Now it's up to the Omen and the Fade, but they're both heaven.
Oh, they heard the shot.
Yeah, cover they going it. Out.
Should both be, they should be aware that both of them are. Oh no.
They're kind of stuck up there.
Last player standing.
Oh, what a deal. Shooting through the hole.
I mean.
Two?
I mean, I guess it's a pretty good save on their part. Again, they're keeping.
I'm no doctor, but I can patch a bullet hole or two. Like, let me know if you need healing.
They're keeping FCC's economy close, like fairly low, but they do need to win a round in order to, like, I mean, make it worth. And like, they just need to win rounds at this point. It is 6-1 on the attack. And it's looking like another A hit with blue and spike here. Instant noise. They're aware.
Yeah, and Ming Boy and actually Rick here, the Rays, pushing out of BFC. They don't have a hit.
Oh, Mina went in there. Get back. Oh! Oh, he accidentally dashed back into the box.
Spike planted.
Shit. Mina pops the Empress.
I think the Rays saw it. Oh, he gets Mina.
I think you res here. Oh, did she do? She opted not to res.
One enemy remaining.
Oh, which might not matter, but Matland chugs.
Satchel out. Very interesting duel here, but
oh, he misses. Oh, he saw
and the Raze gets the kill.
And he does have enough time to defuse. So, again, this is where that, like, this is where the economy starts mattering. Where, like, FCC has been winning a lot of rounds, but at the same time, not a lot of people have been alive. So they have one more buy here. However, if Charis wins another one, economy starts getting kind of dicey for them. But it's up to Charis to really just
let's make some chaos.
Convert some rounds here. It's another alien. They hear utility.
Yep.
So they're calling for the rotate with Rick over here.
Nightfall
comes out. Oh, they're not aware that Mengu Matlan Chung's already deep within sight.
So Fade's actually coming up behind Matlan Chung's. Oh, I'm unfortunate, couldn't get the kill.
Last player standing.
Shadows traveling.
I think FCC heard Omen of Heaven, but Matlan Chung.
Oh wow! The timing. This is okay.
Kind of rough for Charis.
Rough for Charis. They do have four ults. Yeah. They're gonna need to start using these. Mina is 16-6. Really putting his team on his back. So it looks like Charis will have a pistol vibe here. Or a pistol, sheriff on Sangam Sal, and then a shorty for
I've Rick. Got your trail.
And they do pop the jet bolts. Maybe they would pop the jet bolt.
Yeah, they're really using Who's that to get next? On the site. You know, you're catching the owner.
Oh, wow. Mango Boy's gonna have to make this work out. He's gonna need to hit some crisp shots here. Oh, he saw one.
Spike planted.
They hear the wall.
Oh, he missed.
And actually, Mina coming up behind. Last
player. Okay.
What yeah, I think if,
in these last two rounds on the defense.
I think I'm on Charis. I think I use a timeout here and try to reset, see what's going wrong.
Yeah, I mean, again, like. It's more natural and like, and it's also naturally like this site along with Haven, just the three site maps are more like attacker sided just because like the defense does get thinned out because there's just like just one more site for them to like watch. It looks like it's a 10C attack. Sage used multiple footsteps. They use the Sky Dog.
Alright, they're really committing to this.
One. Mina gets trigged. Oh, instant headshot by Mengu Boy. Oh, but Matt Lunchunks gets a trade. 2v2 retake. Both defenders. Oh, wow.
Oh, whoa. Was that their smoke?
Smoke? Yeah.
Well, they know what the last one is.
Satchel up. Spike planted. One enemy remains.
Oh. I'm surprised they didn't pop Razolt there.
Last round in the half.
Try to get like the first kill
before we lose them.
Yeah. And yeah. Try to get that first kill and then like put him in a 1v1 situation as opposed to, you know, like trying to land, set his aim, and then try to get two kills. But. Again, FCC so far has looked to be the strongest team in this tournament. I don't see them slowing down.
Yeah, they're really just getting in there. The boys behind them.
Mango Boy gets one.
You will not kill my allies.
What?
One enemy remaining.
Wow.
Wow. 3v1 now.
But it is Matt Lanchug.
Oh, 4v1. It is Matt Lanchug. Let's see what he can pull off. Cover, go down.
I've got your trail.
Pops the old.
He has Flash Online. One flash online. Oh! Mango Boy with a great swing and instant headshot. 9-3 on FCC's attack. Again, this is an attack-sided map, so it could very well... So, you never know. You win pistol. It's assumed that you win second round as well. That brings that 9-5. Pretty close game at that point. Okay. Alright, looking like it's gonna be a B hit. For Charis. Thorn is here with the Sage Wall. One of the more powerful tools in this game, particularly in pistol rounds, just because like the pistols just don't do enough damage to break it. But it's looking like it's gonna be a fast B hit. So if they're able to beat the Sage Wall and destroy it instantaneously. might go in their favor for Charis.
Yeah, but they gotta go quick.
They gotta go fast and destroy it before it builds. Oh.
Oh, but the rotate.
They rotate to C.
Cover going up. Okay, there's no one on the defense.
There's no one in C right now.
Yeah.
And they're able to set up their own wall. Rick gets two and the spawns 3v3 retake, but Mina is still alive. Blue gets one on the Omen. Mina slowly creeping up this through the smoke. I think he's aware that someone's close by. Omen is on top of the smoke.
Last player standing.
Somebody else gets the kill. Only one health on the stage, and Blue instantly peeks and gets the kill. Okay, again, get pistol. Try to win second round. At that point, you never know. It looks really, like FCC, especially like they win this round, they break FCC's money. So FCC opts to buy 5 singers with light armor, and Charis with the 3 Spectres, Stinger, and the Bulldog. And full armor, so anyone's game here.
Yeah, I think FCC really wants to break this momentum from Charis with that full stinger pushing the buy.
Wow.
It's NPB.
Wow, Mangu Boy gets the second kill. Oh, wow, Mina gets the kill through the smoke. The aggression on sight.
Up in their faces in that smoke. It's now down to a 1v2.
Oh! Rick was trying to. Rick was really trying to get that knife. Okay, here. This is what I mean, where the force fails. And. Charis can really start building this bank to catch up because FCC has upgraded pistols to, again, another set of SMGs, Scout, and that rifle, so, and that Bulldog. So, looking, 9-6 looking likely, very likely here. Another hard B push here. They're cautious of someone being on top of it.
Behind it. Oh, the rage!
Oh, the rage!
Pick.
Oh.
Well, actually, like,
you are lit, my friend. You are very lit.
They get onto B side, but.
Oh, no, oh get... the smoke aggression! Oh, that's information that both of them are on heaven. There's a Mangu Boy.
One enemy remaining.
Boy.
Oh, Mangu Boy with a triple kill. Okay. Woo! They're here. Alright. 9-6. I mean, Charis still with this SMG bank can now afford to really just. If they can, like. It's not looking like they're gonna win just because they have gun disadvantage, but if they can get like 3-4 kills, they really break once again FCC's economy here. So I think the goal right now is not to win the round, but take as much money out as possible. But obviously you want to win every round.
Yes. Oh, but looks like Mangu Boy actually cleared B. They're rotating to site now.
Mangu Boy here with the rotate, hearing the rotate that's from the waterfall.
Shadows traveling.
Okay, coming out of heaven. There's so much going on.
Oh my god, there's so much going on.
But what a retake.
One enemy remaining. Oh. Last player standing.
Oh! Matt Len chugs with the kill. However, again, if you look at the money, money's not looking good for FCC. And it's second half, but this is the first time that Charis is getting rifles. And they were able to turn this game around. So, I mean, it's looking rough. Things are looking up for Charis here.
Charis keeps this up, and they keep constantly breaking FCC's money. I think they have a good chance.
They have a very good chance of turning this game around. Yeah.
Yeah.
And possibly winning it.
I'll find
you.
Another
blue. Blue hit. Oh, but Mina does get
the blue. Oh, you too.
Mina gets three. Wow.
Okay,
blue does get the one kill on A.
Yeah, so they're rotating over.
That is Charis's worst nightmare, allowing Mina to get three there. Okay, it's still 3v3.
Yeah, good pick on the Yoru.
Where are you?
Oh wow, can't believe he took that fight.
Last player standing.
Mina with the 5k. Doesn't really count as an ace because there is a res that was online, but it's a 5k with, wow. That is a backbreaker if you're a Charis.
As much as this world hurt me, it's mine.
I mean, they still have one more buy, but now this means that FCC, it allows FCC to buy as well. Foreigner Mina can buy a rifle for the Yoru. And it's looking like Charis, money's not looking good. Three rifles, Stinger, and the shotgun, but they do have jet knives.
Fire in the hole! Cut in the vision.
Oh! Instant kill with the rocket! I think that's his first kill of the day. Mengu boy aggresses the smoke. Heaven? Gets the kill. Gets two. He gets a kill while he was stunned.
Wild concussed.
Mango boy. Coming up huge. They really need this round.
They really need every round.
One enemy remaining.
Mango boy with the third Mango kill.
Boy. Now to the omen.
Here's footsteps.
Okay, yeah, I thought after that last round, Charis will be mentally like,
oh, they spotted
it. But dude, they came with
blue with a kill. Okay! Okay! After that last round, you would think that Charis's mental was broken, but they went for an instant aggression, does not a care in the world, and once more breaks FCC's money. Alright! They just can't play into Charis's hands because there is still a rifle on foreign here. Holding C by himself. So, couple of headshots here, couple of headshots there.
Yeah, I think FCC kind of so changed up their play positions here.
Oh. Forn and Mina both have rifles.
Healing.
Mango boy back up in heaven.
Mango boy gets a kill through the smoke! No way! This man is nuts! Mango boy!
Lock in sight.
Oh, Mina. Mina?
One enemy remaining.
Was that through smoke?
I have possibly. Okay, foreign. Looks like he's gonna save this.
Yeah, I think he pretty much has to
save. He has to save at this point. I think the rest of his team can buy. Just looking at the money right now. So, And Charis is rich. Charis can possibly buy for the next 2-3 rounds. But again, 11-8. Charis does have res and... Oh no. My apologies. FCC has the res. Charis has Nightfall and Jet Knives. Actually, FCC has every ult.
They have all their ults.
They have all their ults. I don't know what they're planning, but I'm assuming that like they would like use the Yoru ult early for info, or the Sky ult early.
Yeah, this might be the round they use all their ults.
Oh, he failed the drop jump! Oh, he gets two! Oh my god!
2 brave, 4 3 4 5 5 0 8!
The Nightfall makes him aware that someone is Waterfall. He's very curious.
There.
Mangu Boy gets one. Mina gets an instant trade onto Mangu Boy. Are they aware that both of defenders are... They should now be aware that both defenders are here. Oh! We have a game! They break the money once more.
I feel the strain. Block it out, Omen.
Wow. We have a game.
The Jet and the Rays from Charis really...
Yeah, the duelist really stepping up. Yeah. Really stepping up. Again, but FCC, you're still holding on to four ults. I mean, granted, they didn't really have an opportunity last round, but...
Well, we see her three stack on C.
Oh, wow! Again, Charis with this fast-paced aggression. Mangu Boy all the way in their spawn. Again.
The Raze knows that the Sage is here. Gets the pick. Very nice.
Psych is on top of this box watching heaven. Down. Oh! Yoru gets two. Wow, Metlan Trunks.
Remaining.
They know that the Yoru. Wow,
Sam
cleans up. All right, this might be the game here. FCC gets a bye here, and it's looking like Charis has a bye the rest of the round, win or lose this round. The rest of the map, win or lose here. But if FCC. They lose here, their money is broken for round 23. So they're going to really they're leaving B open if you look at this. And that's exactly where Charis is going.
Wow, Charis choosing the right sites. This is crazy. But yeah, they're fully on the site now.
They have
Here.
You're possibly able to get the info.
Mangu Boy is all the way on A side. This is crazy. This is a crazy flank here.
Oh, it's on the side! He gets two!
One enemy remaining.
Mangu Boy with a flank getting me up. What a round.
Wow! Charis! Coming all the way back from 9-3 to tie this game at 11-11. FCC money broken. Do they have it in them? Mina does get a Vandal, the hero Vandal here.
We're gonna have to see some miracle holds from FCC.
Yeah, I mean, it's looking like they're forcing SMGs, but like a lot of them will have enough money for round 24. So they're able to make the money work.
Cover going out.
But. With the Charis going. Wow. Charis just instantly takes sight. See.
Here.
Mangu Boy pushing spawn. Foreign does get a kill. And they do give up one of the rifles. Oh! This aggression from Mango Boy. Mango Boy gets two in spawn. Gets three. Mango Boy gets five. Mango Boy gets the ace for this round. 12. Mango Boy.
Clip that. Someone clip that. I'm clipping that.
Mango Boy. This man is on a mission. I think that nap before the game was really paying off. All right.
Last chance for FCC.
FCC, four of them do have rifles and the shotgun onto the Yoru. Again, this instant B take here with the crazy speed.
Oh, crazy.
Spike down B.
Shot. Oh! 4v2 with Mina popping Empress.
One that enemy remaining.
Oh, wow. Blue. Wow.
Going into overtime.
Overtime.
Wow. Switching sides. Overtime.
What a game, what a game. Now overtime is, you need to win two to win overtime, right?
You need to win two to win overtime, yes.
You know, Charis on defense and FCC attacking. FCC has a heavy B lean. But two defenders on B, so we'll see if this attack is repelled.
Alright. Oh, what? Wow. Mina with a kill through the box.
Yeah. Mango Boy actually pushed up to see. Oh,
Mango Boy gets punished for his push. Psych here. About to meet the entire squad of FCC. Gets one kill, gets two kills.
Traded out by the Sage.
Shadows
trapped. There's 2v3, Matlin Chug. Being the head of this spear, no. There is a flank from the Sage. They do have a plant here.
One enemy remaining.
And they kill the flank.
Oh, this timing?
Blue gets one.
One enemy
Blue gets
remaining.
Two.
Spike
oh, he
down.
Was able to dodge.
Ooh.
Two bullets.
Where are you?
Here's the reload. Wow! Kills him while blind.
That was a good play from the Omen.
Ultimate is ready.
Switching sides. Match point.
Knows with the blind, you just have to run up at them so you can see.
Okay. Charis is now back onto attack. It's looking like they're gonna go for this V hit. FCC looking like they have... Well, looking like they're gonna stack 4C, however. Looks like they're stacking 3B this time around.
Oh, do they know?
But
Charis is going A.
It's going A. The site that's empty. And there's a quick rotation.
They're gonna have such a free.
Decoy.
Here.
Make the boy up in heaven.
Boy up in heaven. They're aware.
Spike planted.
Mina gets one.
Okay. Looks like it's one, but he gets traded by the Omen here. Actually, Matlin Chug's on side.
One enemy remaining.
Oh, Matlin Chug closes it out.
FCC
with 14-12.
What a good game. Wow, this one was crazy.
Defenders win.
What a game.
Oh, Mina, 40-20.
Mina dropping 40-20. Wow. putting his team on his back. Crazy game.
Wow. Alright, but I think this VOD actually will be uploaded instead of the POVs.
Yeah, right. So this VOD will be on YouTube if anyone wants to watch it. Feel free to... and then, again, feel free to follow the channel for the next game. Those games aren't scheduled yet. They will be scheduled... the way the game works, the tournament works, is that we leave it to the teams where whichever... day of the week works for them. So for week 4, again, I believe the games are going to be Grace Avenue versus FCC, and San Diego versus Charis with CCSB having the bye. Right. Thank you for everyone who watched the game, and thank you for your support.